Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 35. Today we're going to do the change to target brush. Now, no, this does not mean that you're going to start painting target symbols on your image. This means that you're going to change a color to a target color based upon a target mode. This is a really cool brush. This mixes together the lighten, the hue, and the saturation brush all together and includes a color option. This is a very powerful brush. This takes all of the options previously given, gives you a little bit more control so that you actually know what you're getting into. This is something I can find a use for. I'm going to show you right off the bat how this works. First, you come over to your materials palette and you set a material. I'm going to get a blue. No, I'm going to get a green. I like green. Green's a cool color. I'm going to come up here to mode. Now, mode is where you determine how it draws. Will it change the color? Will it simply change the hue? If you change the hue, it keeps the saturation and the lightness settings. Will you replace the lightness with the lightness for your new brush? Will you change the saturation to your new color? You know, so many options. The recommendation is for color, because color does more than just change, you know, the hue or the saturation or the lightness. It actually affects all three of those values to a certain amount. Set your opacity to a low setting and start painting it in. Ta-da! It's very nice. You just change the color. Now, of course, it builds on top of itself, so you can use stroke here as well. If I change it to hue, you can see we're only changing the hue, but everything else remains the same. It's not as dramatic an effect as the color was. And of course, if you adjust opacity, you get an even bigger effect. Saturation, it's a very saturated green, so we'll get a very saturated color. Here, when we change it by saturation only, it's like a saturation up-down brush on steroids. You know, I can determine how saturated my color is, and that will determine how saturated the resulting color here is. So that's very nice. Lightness I don't like as much, because when you change all of that to a single lightness value, you're going to get some weird colors. So lightness is only useful on a very flat colored area. So the second you start adding those extra bits, it just throws everything off. So more like for graphics than for photos is what I would use lightness for. But that's me. Undo that. And so it's a very, very simple tool. You determine what mode. The preferred mode is color for most things. You determine your color, which includes how saturated and how light the color is. You affect the opacity for the strength. Step can also come in on this, because it will determine how much of the opacity setting is put down, how close together, yada, yada, yada. You can have a lot of fun with this brush. This brush mixes those three brushes I didn't have a use for and gives them a use. That's why I love this brush so much. So it's a really cool brush. I suggest you try it out. Lots of fun.